Halloween, everyone. It's Tracy of Move Daily Fitness. I'm so glad that you joined us for today. Great idea to get a real good hearty workout in before you go trick-or-treating tonight, or maybe you're just having friends over and there's lots of treats around. Let's do this boot camp workout together, okay? We're gonna burn a ton of calories in today's workout. Everything's very high intensity. And the only thing that you'll need is maybe one medicine ball or one dumbbell, okay? I'm gonna do one exercise requiring the medicine ball, but if you don't have one, just grab one dumbbell for it. You're just gonna be lifting it over your head. Or you can grab a pumpkin. Unless it's December, then you can't grab that pumpkin. So you know what, forget the pumpkin, grab a medicine ball. All right, if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, make sure that you do so, and make sure you click that little bell beside the subscribe button, because that turns on your notifications and you'll get a reminder when I put out new videos, which this next week is going to be every single day. Woo! Yes, more cheering, yes. Because we have our workout wellness week coming up November 1st to 7th, and I'm gonna be putting a video out every single day, as well as wellness tips to help you on your journey towards a better, healthier you. All right, so grab your water, get ready for a full variety of format. I'm not even gonna explain the formats right now, but before each one, I'll let you know what's coming up, because it's gonna be harried, it's gonna be crazy, and we're gonna do it coming up right now. Let's start with the warm up. Okay, so here's the first little sequence. You're gonna do 10 of this exercise, then 20, 30, 40, 50, then we're gonna reverse it for 50, 40, 30, 20, 10. All right, so there's no timing. Follow along. Now, if you're not in the same rep range as I am, just switch when I switch so that we can stay on track with each other, okay? Don't worry about falling behind, or you can even go further ahead, that's fine, but just keep on track with me and we'll do this whole workout together. All right, we're starting with 10 squat jumps. Ready? Here we go. 10 right here. Little squat jumps, of course, modify without the jump if you want. 5 more. 3, 2, front lunges coming up. Here we go. We've got 20, so 10 each side. 2, good. This is a little harder for me to talk because I've got a count as opposed to just relying on the timer, but that's all right. It's fun, it's different, and it's neat to switch it up sometimes. All right, I think that's 10, 10 more here. Alternating front, dropping that back knee low. I touch the ground, so I get a nice deep stretch in that. Last 5 here. Going down for 30 mountain climbers, coming up in 2 and 1. All right, take it down to mountain climbers. Here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I'll keep counting. There's 10. Halfway. 20. Six, seven, eight, nine, and 30. Good job, let's come up. 40 ice skaters, here we go. 1, 2. Stay low, that's 10. 20. Halfway. 30. 5 knees are coming up in 4, 3, 2, and 1. 50 high knees. Here we go. 10. 20. 30. 40. 50. Whew. Okay, catch your breath for a second. Now we're gonna kick that into the opposite direction, starting with the 50 high knees again. Ready? And here we go. 10, 20, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. All right, ice skaters for 40 here. This is quite the hearty workout, isn't it? Warm up, I mean. Like, we're getting right at it. No lollygagging here. That's 20. Whew. 30. 9. And 40. All right, let's hit those alternating front lunges. Oh, sorry, mountain climbers for 30. Here we go. Ten. 20. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now your front lunges for 20. Here we go. 3, 4. Stay tall, nice tight tummy. 10 more. Hey, make sure you stay tuned to the end. I've got a great testimonial from one of our YouTube subscribers. She wrote me an email. Oh my goodness. Her transformation's been quite something. I want to share that with you at the end, so look for that. One more here. All right, 10 squat jumps. Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Oh. Now I'm warm and ready to go. All right, grab water, join me for the next circuit. Here's your next little circuit. You've got three different exercises. We're gonna do an up chain. So we're gonna start at one rep, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, then we'll take three other exercises and do a down chain. So you've got the squat jack, the push up to ankle tap, and the partial burpee. 1, then 2, all the way up to 10. Ready? Start with the squat jack, here we go. Squat jack, push up, ankle tap. Tap 1, partial burpee 1. All right, 2 of each. 2 squat jacks, 2 push-ups. Push up, tap. This can be done from the knees if you need. 2 partial burpees. All right, 3. Low, 2, 3 push-ups, push-up, tap, push-up, last one here, 3 burpees, partial, 1, 2, 3, all right, 4 of each, 1, squat jack, 2, 3, push-ups, 1, 2, last one here, 4 partial burpees, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 push-ups, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 partial burpees, 6. One, two, three, four, five, six. Push-ups. One. Bum goes way up in the air here. Three. Four. Five. Six partial burpees. Here we go. Seven squat jacks. Here we go. Three, four, five, six. All right, seven push-ups. If you need to break and pause the camera or video, fine. Make sure you do that. Listen to your body. Two more in here. Here's six. Seven. Seven partial burpees. Okay, moving to eight. Ready? Let's go. Eight. Seven, eight push-ups. Here, because you can do extras, remember, right? Okay, 10 of each. Ready? Squat jacks, here we go. One, two, three, seven, eight, nine, 10 push-ups. Let's go. One, last two here.
9.
All right, last 10 partials, here we go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, oh, good job. Okay, take a well-deserved break and join me back for the down chain. This whole down chain now is gonna be done on the floor. So get down here. If you have that medicine ball, grab it. If you have a weight, grab that. I'll show you both modifications. Here's your three exercises. So again, we're gonna now start 10 of each and go down to one. All right, so you have the V-sit ball toss. So you're here, toss that up like that. If you don't have that, you're just pressing here, okay? And then we're gonna go into a weighted Russian twist as well as some plank jacks. All right. Starting with 10. Let's start with that ball or your dumbbell. In 3, 2, here we go for 10, 9, 8, 6, 5, woo, 4, 3, 2. All right, 10 Russian twists. Use the ball or your weight if you want or nothing. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right, 10 plank jacks. Flip it over, plank position. Jack those legs. Here we go. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, all right, go to 9 of each. Back to your V-sit. Ooh, 2, this is hard. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, ooh, 9. Okay, Russian twist, 9, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, plank jack. 9, 10, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, 8 of everything. Here we go. 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 2. Oh, that one's hard. I feel like I'm tipping backwards. 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Plank jacks. 8. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, 7s. Russian twist. Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Plank jacks. 5, 6, 7. Sixes. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Russian twist. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Jacks. This one's going by fast. Go. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fives. I'm gonna go right into that Russian twist from this one. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Jacks. A lot of flipping up and down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fours. Moving quickly now. 4, 3, 2, 1. 4, 3, 2, 1. 4, 3, 2, 1. Can you beat me? Go, girls. Come on, let's go. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, Russian. 3, 2, 1, plank. Oh, I'm gonna flip this way. 3, 2, 1, twos. 1, 2, Russian. 1, 2, jack. 1, 2, 1 of each. Here we go. 1, 1, and 1. Okay, that was fast moving. Good, grab water. Let's move on to the next fun thing. here's your next form rep. We're gonna do an AM rep. So as many reps as possible. I've got three different exercises for you. You're gonna do 8 reps of each, and we're just gonna cycle through those 3 exercises for 10 minutes. All right, here's the exercises. You've got some up-down planks, you've got some jumping lunges, and we've got an X position abs, all right? So let's just get going. Try to stay with me with my rep range. If not, you can count to yourself, that's totally fine. It's gonna be a fun 10 minutes. Let's get started. All right, starting with those up-down planks, we've got 8. I'm gonna do 4 each lead arm. You can do them however you like. There's 3. All right, switch lead arms. This can be done from the knees to modify. And here's 8. Jumping lunges for 8. Now, to modify, you can do reverse lunges. That's fine too. 6, 7, and 8. On your back. 8 X position abs. So body's in the position of an X, and move all the way up and touch hands to legs. 6, 7. All right, good. Repeating, that took me 50 seconds. Here we go, up, down, plank. 8. And X position abs. 2 minutes and 30 seconds in. I know. Keep going. That's 4. You can just break as you need. Jump in when you can again. Lunges. Position. Remember, you can modify these if you're starting to fatigue from the knees for that. Here we go. Eliminate the jump for this. And you can just do a regular little V-sit like this or a crunch for this one. Yeah.
goodness. All right, keep going. Halfway there. Whew. You take a break if you need. Jumping lunges. How are we doing, guys? 6 minutes in, 4 to go. It's a round, almost take me a minute per round, a little less. Let's go. Four more here. Jumping lunges. I think right now the lunges are my favorite. Feels like they're the easiest. Go. X position. Whew. This winter, fall, sun is really annoying because it's lower, it's not so high in the air. So it's beaming in my window all the time now. I feel like I need to get some blackout blinds and just use the lighting system because it's so sporadic behind the clouds. So I apologize for the lighting on the videos. It's not the best, I know. Woo! Keep going. One more right here. Yew! Lunges. Eight. Somehow doing the eight is actually not so bad compared to like 12 reps, right? Okay, less than 2 minutes left. Let's go. Where ya? How you guys doing? You know what I didn't do? Keep track of how many rounds I got. What the heck? That's the best part. Why didn't I do that? Ugh. Well, hopefully you did, and you can tell me in the comments below how many rounds we did, or how many rounds you did if you beat me. Here we go. Eight. Yes. 1 minute, guys. One more, up, okay, keep going, still 40 seconds left. Jumping lunges next, hopefully I won't get to those again. Here we go. Exposition abs. Come on, you got 5 seconds here. 4, 3, 2, 1 more, one more. Woo-hoo. Oh, that was hard.
Here's your next format. So I've got 10 different exercises. One is up, one is down on the ground, one is standing, one is down on the ground. Okay, alternating like that for 10 exercises. We're gonna do 30 seconds of each with just 10 seconds in between, and we'll repeat it once, twice. Well, we'll do it twice. Is that repeat once or twice? Anyway, follow me because I'm leading. All right, ready? Let's do it. Up and down, starting with up. We're gonna climb the ladder, okay? Running, climbing that ladder, getting the knees up high in 3, 2, and here we go. Up, that's it. Whew. All right, those first three things were kind of fun. I liked that first up chain. That was challenging. The second one went by fast. It wasn't that hard, but it was good. Let's see if we can increase our heart rates a little bit with this one. Good, you got 10 seconds left. Then we're gonna go down on the ground for some fire hydrants. In 3, 2, and rest. All right, let's take it down to the ground. You're gonna do a fire hydrant like this from your knees, but pop it into a hover position and then go out to the side. Ready? Here we go. Up. So a little bit more challenge on that quad that's stabilizing you. Just 15 seconds aside on this guy. That's probably all I can take on that quad. All right, switch legs and up. Good. You are hovering over the ground here. That's it, 5 seconds. And then we're standing for a line hop. Woo, good. Okay, come to standing. Pretend there's an imaginary line. We're hopping side to side. In 3, 2, let's go. Let's go. Inchworm to tuck. Someone told me in the comments below that they hated inchworms. Now guess what we're doing? Thanks to her. Everyone can thank her. I can't remember who it was, but I said, you shouldn't tell me that you don't like an exercise because you know what's coming next, don't you? Well, here it comes. Woo! Okay, standing position, walking up to plank, walk back, tuck jump. So we're getting down and up. Here we go. And walk it out. Plank, walk it back, jump it up, walk. Oh, tuck, bring the knees up, here we go. Knees up. Get all the way down to plank, bum is flat. 7 seconds. 3, 2, done, good job. Okay, squat roundhouse. Squat position, low, sweeping leg up and over, start. Let's go, up, get low. I want you to drop those glutes as low as you can there. Good. Single leg push-up coming up. So, I'm gonna cross my legs behind me. So I take away the center of balance, making it a little bit more difficult. I'll show you from your knee as well. 3, 2, time. All right, from your knee, try to do it just from one knee like that. Otherwise, feet are in plank, cross behind. Ready? Start. It out. Let's go here. Really quick. I'll call halfway. We'll switch legs and arms.
jumping forward. That's it. Hands up high by your face. All right, switch legs quick, go. That's it. What's next? Spider-Man crunches coming up. Fast, fast right here, come on. 3, 2, good. Whew. Okay, get down. Spider-Man crunches. Plank position, knee comes out to the side. Start, up, and up. Halfway. Ice skater jumping lunge next. All right, I'm standing. Okay, ice skaters, we'll drop that back knee to lunge. Ready, big jump sideways, lunge. Jump, lunge. I'm touching my knee to the ground there. Do it if you can. If not, just get as low as you can. Scorpions, last one here. Then a little break and then a repeat. Ten seconds. Three, two, woo. Okay. Plank position. You're flipping it over that scorpion. Just hold plank to modify. Ready? Here we go. Flip. Opposite hand, opposite toe, touch. Bum is down. Woo. In 4, 3, 2, all right. Grab a quick water. Don't leave, you got this to do this again. Let's go. One more round of this up and down exercise, starting with that climb the ladder, okay? Get those knees up, ready. Let's do it. Okay. I made this one short today because I'm sure you got a lot to do to get ready for Halloween if you guys are celebrating that. Kids gotta get their costumes and, you know, you got stuff to do, so we're in and out. But with this workout, you're burning upwards of 400 calories depending on your intensity, so work as hard as you can in this short time, okay? Get the most bang for your buck. Almost there, going to fire hydrants. Whew. Okay, let's take it down. I can hear my neighbor's vacuuming her car. It's very loud. She should vacuum mine. Ready, hover, and hydrate. Here. Up. Can you guys hear that? I'm doing this, it's Saturday morning actually when I'm filming this. So, one more, switch sides. So people are out and about, doing their errands and such, which is what we'll be doing shortly. Up. This is hard in the hover. Who knew? I originally just had that fire hydrant, I'm like, that's too easy. These girls can do more than that, is what I said to myself. Line hop, ready, go. Hop side to side, nice and quick. Let's go, let's go. Jump up there, okay? In 3, 2, walk it out. Start down, right by your feet. Walk all the way back to your feet. Bring those knees up. Up. 10 seconds. Give me a good big jump on that tuck. It's fun. Spring. Woo! In 3, 2, last one. Is it fun? That's a weird thing to say. Squat roundhouse. Ready. Let's do it. Go. Up and over. That's it. I gotta be careful not to lean forward because I'm fatiguing in this squat. Keep it like a sumo. Drop your glutes low. Okay? Good. What's next? Single leg push up. Okay. Knees or toes. Done a lot of push ups today, haven't we? Ready? And start. In 3, 2, last one. That's hard. Okay. Single leg push-ups. Quick punches is next. You're low. Hop forward. Let's go. Four, three, two. Switch sides. Go. Boom. That's it. Spider-Man crunches are next. Down on the ground. And boom. Okay, two more. After that, Spider-Man crunches, ice skating lunges, and scorpions. Ready? Left, okay? Let's go. Lunge, drop, and drop. That's it. A lot harder than just an ice skater here. Stay tall. Don't lose form. Scorpions are last. Okay. You got this. In 3, 2, start. One, two, three. Toe tap. Legs out, those legs a little bit there, maybe the chest from all those push-ups. Woo! I gotta get a little sweat on. What was that, like 35, 40 minutes? Not long, but enough to go, you know what, I worked out. I'm gonna have some mini chocolate bars. Maybe. Maybe I'll have some lollies. Who knows what I'll indulge in tonight. Oh, good stretch there. But anyway, it probably burnt upwards 350, 400, calories depending on your intensity. So remember though, all those little chocolate bars add up, right? I think the lowest, if you're thinking the candy bar, the lowest calorie one is 50. And then you have something like a Coffee Crisp or O. Henry, and those are up by 90. All right, so you pop three of those, and your workout for the day is basically flush, which is fine. Let's go into a butterfly stretch. If that's why you work out, so you can have those little treats, that's great. If you're trying to lose body fat, all of those things hinder, right? Not to mention they spike your insulin levels because of the sugar load in them and the refined carbs. So have it, but in moderation, right? Or, you know, I always follow that adage, the 80-20 principle, because that is how I live my life. Like, I'm not gonna not have stuff. Let's stretch out that hamstring right here. The camera looks really dark right now, sorry. It was so sunny that I shut the blinds and now it's like black. Fits with our Halloween theme though, doesn't it? 80-20 principle, yeah, is that 80% of the time for the rest of your life, you think consciously about your food choices switch. You're eating healthy, you are eating lots of fruits and vegetables. Well, maybe not a lot of fruits because those are high in sugar too, but lots of micronutrients and fiber in there, so don't shy away from that stuff, but just choose the low sugar ones like your berries, right? But yeah, that's, for me, that's what life is about, with the moderation, right? Not totally neglecting certain food groups because I feel like for me, that's not fully sustainable for the long haul. But I can go my whole weekday eating healthy and clean and then having some treats on the weekend. And again, in moderation, not throwing the baby out with the bathwater and do like a 5,000 calorie challenge. I'm just gonna eat my face off. I actually hate those because it makes people think that they can all do it. And if you have a weight issue and you don't become mindful about food, like, that's part of the wellness growth. You've got to become mindful about your relationship with food and some of the triggers that you have, right? So when you watch someone like consume whatever 10,000 calories of food on their cheat day, I just don't think that's a healthy mindset, right? And I feel like a lot of young people do that, and it gives the impression that everyone can do that. But again, it's not a fully sustainable way to live because it's really not treating your body with the respect it deserves by shoving 10,000 calories down your throat, in my opinion. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. All right, I said I was gonna read you this little email from one of our subscribers because it brought joy to my heart, and I'm sure it'll bring joy to yours as well. All right, she writes, "Good morning, Tracy. I started working out to your online videos about 3 months ago. I was fed up, feeling fat, unattractive, depressed, and just overall not happy. I decided to log my food into a diary and work out 4 days a week. First month was hard. I was 234 pounds heavy, and even at my frame of 5'10", that is a lot. But I persevered. Arms, legs, abs, booty, back, everything got worked hard, and I kept logging my food daily too. I set myself a target of max 1800 cals a day and minimum of 1450 calories a day on the days I worked out. On the days I didn't work out, I was okay if I got 1300 calories. So she set herself, you know, into a structured logging plan, kind of like MyFitnessPal does. But as the time progressed, I not only tracked my calories, I also watched my macros closely. Being a vegan, that's always fun. I hear you, girl, that is hard. And I started working out 5 days a week. Now the weight was not only slowly starting to melt away, it was falling off. We're in our third month, and now I eat around 1,700 calories daily, work out in the gym 5 days a week, and 1 day a week at home, plus 4 days a week I run with my dogs, learning to run to be precise. And I'm down to 198 pounds. My goal weight is 154, so only 36 pounds gone, 44 pounds to go. I feel I can really do it this time, Tracy, and it's thanks to your positive approach, your amazing workouts, and your motivating chats, like this one. If I lived in Canada or the US, I'd fly over just to meet you. Oh, I love you. So since living in Ireland, all I can do is send you a quick email to say thank you, because I have a feeling that you are about to change my life for good." That is awesome. I love that. And again, it's sustaining it for the long haul, doing the things. People like us do things like this. Fit people work out consistently. They think about their food regularly, make conscious decisions to move daily in their fitness, wellness, and nutrition.
All right, go enjoy your Halloween. Have a great time. Hey, and if you like the boot camp style video, go ahead and click or tap the screen right here. That's our playlist for boot camps. There's only one other one in there right now, but it's gonna grow because I think you guys like this. All right, or if you want like power hours, those are like the strength ones, click or tap the screen right there. I'll see you in the next video.